Hi everybody, how you doing? In today's video, I want to talk just a little bit about masks. I've been collecting data, reading articles, paying attention the entire pandemic, and I've recently decided to up my game. I thought I'd tell you what I'm wearing next and why. When the pandemic started, we were told we didn't have to wear masks, and then we were told that we needed to. What was lacking was any sort of information on which were better than others and how effective they were. Now, following articles, I read about a lot of spreading events, and it became obvious really quick that all of them were related to people not wearing a mask at all. I didn't see any that were linked to touching or eating. People would get it, say, in a restaurant or a bar, but nobody was getting it from home delivery pizzas. So it became obvious to me early that touching wasn't the problem, eating contaminated food wasn't the problem. It was breathing, and the masks were doing something. That is, masks do something good. But which ones are better? Let's start with the neck gaiters. So you've probably seen these. These will not hurt your ears. These are great. The problem is they're a single layer cloth, and they don't do anything. They don't protect you. They don't protect the people around you. There was a study that found that people's breath was being atomized, potentially making the spread even worse. Now, that was a study of some test equipment, not an organized study of masks. Either way, these are at the bottom. Now, homemade masks, they do something. The top of the line of this type are the surgical masks. Now, these are three layer of fabric, even though they don't look like it, and the weave is of a size designed to limit the spread of contagions. You know, these are used in hospitals. A recent Dutch study found that these have effectiveness breathing out, protecting people around you, of about 40%. And more interesting to me was that they protect me about 16%. During the presidential inauguration on 20 January of this year, that was the first time I saw people double masking. And that made me go, ooh, if this mask will give me 16% protection, then if I double mask, maybe they'll give me 32%. You know, something's better than nothing, and the bigger the number, the better. I also noticed that when I was wearing these this way, they're actually kind of more comfortable. They fit better. So maybe I actually get more than 32% protection on it. At this point here, it is six layers of fabric, and it's pretty tight seal around here. And honestly, it's not any harder to breathe. It's been a long road, and I've behaved myself. Last thing I want to do is be sloppy, catch the virus in the last mile of this journey, and risk serious health hazards. I look around, and there are people who just refuse to behave themselves, refuse to wear masks. I have to up my game. This is what I bought. I bought a KN93 and a KN95. Now these are similar to the US standard N95, for example. The K means it's made in China. And of course there is the concern might be counterfeits. Now I cut one of these things open and I found four layers, each of different types of fabric. There was also a little certificate in there saying, you know, certified by the Chinese government. The latest article I read online was for the fakes, was they have a little certificate in there saying certified by a US government agency. That doesn't happen. This is a Chinese product, not an American product. A KN93 is supposed to give you protection about 88%. And a KN95 is supposed to give you protection about 95%. And block all of any water droplets that's leaving your mouth protecting everybody around you far better than any of the other masks do it. But how do they look and how do they feel? So I've worn this 93 for about a week, and got the metal squeezes up here, and I find that it works pretty well. I feel more protected, it's more comfortable, it's not hard to breathe through it, and one of the tests is putting glasses on. I have much less trouble with my eyeglasses fogging up when I'm wearing this from a surgical mask. I have to say that the KN95 I like better. Although, you know, it makes me look like a duck. The fit is better still. It's easier to breathe. And, you know, we're wearing this for safety reasons, not to win a fashion contest. In a previous video, I talk about ways of sanitizing your mask. Something like a KN95, although it only costs $2 each, I don't want to throw them away after every use. I was looking up on the NIH and found some interesting information. For example, the virus will die after 3 minutes at a temperature of 160 degrees. Something like this, looking at the specs, the fabric doesn't get damaged until it's subjected to about 210 degrees. If I put this into a preheated oven at 170 degrees for, say, 5 minutes, it should sanitize the mask. I've done it, and I don't have a laboratory, I'm not a doctor, but you know when you wear these things, they get kind of biological stinky? It came out of it smelling very fresh. I hope you have a great rest of your day.